know, while we have made a lot of progress in Virginia, slavery has ended, schools have been desegregated, we have ended the Jim Crow laws, easier access to voting, it is abundantly clear that we still have a lot of work to do. And I really think this week raised a level of awareness in the Commonwealth and in this country that we haven't seen certainly in my lifetime.
And why you think you still deserve this job when so many people are calling for you to step down?
Well, again, we have worked very hard. We've had a good first year, and I'm a leader. I've been in some very difficult situations, life and death situations, taking care of sick children. And right now,
you're a doctor, yes.
Right now, Virginia needs someone that can heal. There's no better person to do that than a doctor. Virginia also needs someone who is strong, who has empathy, who has courage, and who has a moral compass. And that's why I'm not going anywhere. I have learned from this. I have a lot more to learn. But we're in a unique opportunity now. Again, the 400-year anniversary of the history, whether it be good or bad, in Virginia, to really make some impactful changes.
Of slavery in this country,
yes.
In this state, yeah. Did you ever think about resigning when the drumbeat became so loud? And by the way, they're still beating for you to step down.
I don't live in a vacuum. And
yes.
So, yes, I have heard it. And I've had, this has been a difficult week. And again, I'm fine. It's been mainly difficult for Virginia and this country. So yes, I have thought about resigning, but I've also thought about what Virginia needs right now. And I really think that I'm in a position where I can take Virginia to the next level, and it will be very positive. And you know, we have a number of inequities in this country right now and in Virginia, and we're in a position to really stop talking so much and now to take action with policy to address a lot of these inequities.